Hands locked before talks, walks, and John Hancock's.
We're signing a very important document.
A joint agreement coming from Donald Trump and Kim Jong-un as they wrapped up a historic summit in Singapore.
Chairman Kim and I just signed a joint statement in which he reaffirmed his unwavering commitment to complete denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula.
While Trump says he expects the denuclearization process to start right away, exactly how it would be achieved isn't clear. Following the first ever meeting between a sitting U.S. president and a North Korean leader, two men who just months ago exchanged long-distance insults and threats.
President, what surprised you the most about Chairman Kim?
Great personality and very smart. Good combination.
A surprise announcement coming from Trump at his post-summit news conference.
We will be stopping the war games, which will save us a tremendous amount of money, unless and until we see that the future negotiation is not going along like it should.
Through a spokesperson, the U.S. military forces in Korea say they've not received directions to stop the joint military drills. And South Korea's presidential Blue House says it needs to find out the precise meaning or intentions of Trump's statement. Back in the U.S., reaction coming from both Democratic and Republican senators.
This joint statement is so imprecise. What the United States has gained is vague and unverifiable at best. What North Korea has gained, however, is tangible and lasting.
I don't think canceling a war game is going to matter over the arc of time. The one thing that I would violently disagree with is removing our troops. I can't imagine I would vote for any agreement that requires us to withdraw our forces.
And Republican Senator Marco Rubio tweeting, "While I know POTUS is trying to butter him up and get a good deal, Kim Jong-un is not a talented guy. He inherited the family business from his dad and grandfather. He's a total weirdo who would not be elected assistant dog catcher in any democracy." Following the summit, the United Nations is urging the international community to offer support on steps leading to denuclearization.
As the Secretary General noted in letters to both leaders before the summit, the road ahead requires cooperation, compromise, and a common cause.
And Justin Trudeau weighing in.
We support the continuing efforts by the president on North Korea. We look forward to looking at the details of the agreement.
So can Kim be trusted? Trump answering that question in his first post-summit interview.
Kim is a brutal dictator. He runs a police state, forced starvation, labor camps. He's assassinating members of his own family. How do you trust a killer like that?
George, I'm given what I'm given, okay? I mean, this is what we have, and this is where we are, and I can only tell you from my experience, and I met him, I've spoken with him, and I've met him, and this was, as you know, started very early, and it's been very intense. I think that he really wants to do a great job for North Korea. I think he wants to denuke. It's very important. Without that, there's nothing to discuss.
So what's next? Well, the U.S. Secretary of State and North Korean officials expected to hold talks soon. But what if they're not successful? We'll leave you with one last word from Trump.
I think, honestly, I think he's going to do these things. I may be wrong. I mean, I may stand before you in 6 months and say, hey, I was wrong. I don't know that I'll ever admit that, but I'll find some kind of an excuse.